Update my 30. You 32. Of 6 months has changed her behavior recently, and I want to lead. Some things I want to address first at work. Same place I've done for years because of my anxiety. I know how to do everything at my... When I said I'm basically a manager, I mean that I do sometimes fill in shifts and responsibilities for them. And we have talked about me officially being manager before, but it's not what I want. I don't want to take my work home with me and never be able to switch off, like I see some of them do. That said, I do want to have some more ambition in my life going forward, and I am going to be looking at other ventures. My clothes, my band clothes, are now back at my house. I still have the new clothes we bought, as I paid for a lot of them, and I plan to continue wearing them too. I can see what she meant by wanting me to wear new clothes. I just didn't like her end goal, or the way she went about. For the people thinking I dress like those goth people dancing under a bridge, I don't. It's usually just a band tee slash jumper with some normal jeans. I'm not a teenager. Just a 30-year-old still loves the same band, haha. No hate to those dancing goths. I love that meme. So, on to the main story. I took advice from some of the responses to the op. We live separately, so there wasn't any issues with leases, but I did change my lockers. I'd given her a key a few months ago. As for the breakup, I was at home thinking of how to do it. Which cafe slash restaurant I was gonna do it in, etc. She finished work and came to mine without any prior discussion. Not out of the ordinary, to be fair. Anyway, she could tell something was off. And because I'd been thinking about it all for hours, I was 150% sure I wanted to do it. So just did it here instead. I first told her that I had lied about donating my clothes, and that I'd actually taken them to work instead. She was angry and calling me a liar and everything. I apologized for it and tried to explain that I felt a lot of unfair pressure to get rid of them when I didn't really want to and my collection wasn't hurting anyone. I don't really feel that the argument was fair, and I feel that her actions made me lie to her, but I hate saying stuff like that, so I just left it and moved on. I then told her I was really annoyed about her calling my boss. She said she was sorry, but I should be a manager. Then I just said I didn't want to be with her anymore because she actually had given me a second to speak. She looked shocked and asked me what I meant. I just said I didn't want to be with her anymore and that I wanted her to leave and would be changing my locks but was open to calling to messaging about picking up her stuff. She said stuff like we don't have to break up, but I kept saying my mind is made up and technically we already had. She called me pathetic as she walked out the door and slammed it behind her. This was the other day. I haven't heard from her, but I sent her a message about picking up her stuff. There isn't much of it here, so maybe she doesn't want to. Anyway, since then, I called my boss to explain that situation and be wary of any contact from her. We've worked together for years and we're good friends, so he was very understanding. And said if I need help in any way, he'll try to provide. We go for drinks often with other colleagues, so I'll explain it all to them, their problem. As for me, like I said above, I do want to work on myself a bit, partly because of the things she said, but not for the same reasons, just for me to grow a bit in terms of work experience and fashion sense. I'll be buying more smart causal clothes to wear as well. I don't think I'll ever fully stop wearing the band clothes, though I don't quite know what I want to do in terms of work. But I have the experience of teamwork and leadership from the store, which I think is usable and transferable to other jobs too. I'm feeling weird. But it feels great to have acted decisively. I haven't felt sad yet. Not happy either, just relieved most. Some of her stuff is still here, and it feels weird to see knowing it'll never be that way again. I don't know how to describe that feeling. Anyway, I've spoken to friends about it and will be seeing them soon. Don't know what she's been up to or what she'll do. Not sure if I want to. There's nothing left for me with her anyway. Just wanted to thank everyone for their kind words in the op. It felt really good to know I wasn't being treated fairly, and I wasn't just being stupid like she said. Some even messaged me with similar stuff or how much they liked their partners with similar habits to my band clothes, which was really nice. One of the reasons I still wear the band tees is sometimes other fans spot them and we'll have a nice conversation about it and always end the conversation smiling, haha, it's just nice. Don't Red came to my house and it took an hour or so, but I broke up with her and she left. Locks have been changed and clothes return. Thins are weird, but definitely better. I'll be working on myself, but doing it purely for me, not for her or anyone else. Thanks again for kind words and advice, everyone. Hope you enjoyed the story. Not everyone wants to move up in their career. That is if you can make what you need, then that is fine. Not everyone is cut out to be a manager. Do what you want. I'm glad you're rid of your girlfriend. She was toxic and so negative. She wanted to change you to her vision of what you should be, not what you actually want. I faced a similar situation and I'm glad you found your way out of it. You wear a uniform for work. That was my issue. I'd wear a uniform and then on my days off, I go see the person I was dating and wanted to be comfortable, so I wore my favorite shirts, hoodies, often band-related, and would be told I needed to grow up slash be called pathetic. After we broke up, I couldn't listen to my favourite band for months and even packed away the clothes because of all the negativity that came during the relationship. I hope you'll be okay moving forward. And if in a few years she comes around trying to be friends, take my advice and don't, because she'll just act this way all over again. That was my experience, at least. I mean, calling your boss. That alone was an instant knob that cannot happen.